Today we're going to talk about playing cards investigation. Here's a deck of playing cards. So what do you know about playing cards? Count the number of playing cards. So if I count, hey, there's no jokers in here. That's weird. Where are my jokers? That's good, because I don't need any jokers here. So if I count the number of playing cards, these come from the Las Vegas Club Hotel and Casino, I count there are 52 playing cards in a standard deck. How many suits are there? Let's see. I see this one, see this suit, and this suit. Suits are categories. How many types of categories do you see? I see there are four suits in a standard deck. Name the four suits. They are this one. Let me draw it. Well, it's upside down. Let me draw it. That is called spades. A spade is like a garden tool that looks like this and used to dig into the ground. Or it also could be as a weapon too. Like they throw it like a javelin, but this is the end of it, it's a spade, and it kills the animal that you're hunting. Next one, hearts. Next one, I used to call this when I was a kid broccoli. So all my friends thought I was an idiot. Said, oh my God, it's not a broccoli. Why do you keep calling it broccoli? So this is called clubs. I do not know why it is called club. It should be called broccoli. And last but not least, diamonds. All right, that's pretty bad. That's a diamond. Diamonds. So there are four suits in a deck of in a standard deck. Of playing cards. They are spades, hearts, clubs, and diamonds. Name the individual cards of each suit. Starts with ace or one. Then you go to ace, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, jack, queen, king. So ace, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, jack, queen, and king. Name the face cards. A face card means it has a person's face on it. Says it's jack, queen, and king. What is the probability of selecting a red card? So, in this stack, there are 52 playing cards. How many red cards are there? Well, all the hearts are red. There are 13 red cards here. All the diamonds are red. There are 13 here. So, 26 out of 52 cards are red. Did you know that's the same thing as saying half of the deck is red, half the deck is black. What is the probability of selecting a club? Club. Oh, these. How many clubs do you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There are 13 clubs out of 52. Stop. How many suits are there? 4. Is it club one of the suit, one of the four? So it's 1/4. Number 7. What is the probability of selecting a face cards? How many face cards do you see here? 1, 2, 3. There are 3 face cards for spades. There are 3 face cards for hearts. There are 3 face cards for clubs. There are 3 face cards for diamond. That's 12 out of 52, which simplifies by divide by 2, 6, divide by 2, what's half of 52? 26, right? Simplify it, 3 out of 13. Out of 13 cards in a suit, 3 of them, of the 13, have a face. What is the probability of selecting a 7? How many 7s will you find in here? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 out of 52. Or 2 out of 26, or 1 out of 13. So that's the study of playing cards. What you're going to be doing now is using this, the deck of playing cards, you are going to create carnival games that are typically constructed so that the probability of losing is higher than the probability of winning. Otherwise, the creator of the game couldn't earn a profit. Create your own carnival game. Calculate the probability of various outcomes. For each carnival scenario, you will either use playing cards, spinners, rainbow cubes, and a number cube. Can you create a carnival game with a number cube that has a 33 1/3% probability of winning. So I have a number cube. So you will win 33⅓%. Let's think. A number cube goes from 1 through 6. So how many numbers? So what can I use, roll, so it'll be a 33⅓% chance of winning? What about if you roll a 1 or 2? That's going to be 2 out of 6 out for 1/3, which is the same thing as saying 33⅓%. So what about rolling a 1 or a 2 to get 33⅓%? Create a carnival game with a rainbow cube, with rainbow cubes that has 10% probability of winning. So let's say if you have 10 rainbow cubes, 7, 8, 9, 10. You make the first rainbow cube red, the other one will be all different types of colors. So if you select red from the bag, it's 1 out of 10 or 10%. Select red from a bag. That will be a 10% chance of winning. Next one. Create a carnival game with a spinner that has a 20% probability of winning. 20% probability of winning using a spinner. Well, what if we divide this into 5 parts? And this will be 1, 2. No, let's use colors. I think colors are easier to use on a spinner. So let's say this is orange, this is blue, this is green, this is yellow, and this is black. If you land on an orange, that's a 1 out of 5 chance or 20% chance of winning. So that's another way. Or if we had done 10 sections of this spinner, you would have to land on orange twice. 2 out of 10, which is 20%. And the last one, if you have a deck of playing cards, a probability of winning 25%. What happens if we do, I don't know, what we know is probability of winning, 1/4. 25% is the same thing as saying 1/4. 1/4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, aren't there 4 suits in here? So what if you pick a spade? There are 13 spades out of 52, which simplify to 1/4. So that is our carnival game. All right, so in it, again, a standard deck has 52 cards. There are 4 suits. There are 13 cards per suit. And it goes from ace all the way to king. Jack, queen, king are the face cards.